soap. Incendio. Jelly. I'm sick of that white rooster of yours, Rose. Some pet that. Look at the lump it took out of my arm.
That's because you don't speak to
him. I know the speaking he'll get from me. The weight of my boot. Chrissy, throw some tire from my fire, would you? I'm going to make some soda bread.
Good chap. She's in one of her cranky moods.
You're 10 miles wood by Maggie.
Great. The tongue's out a mile.
You missed it all, Maggie.
What did I miss this time?
We were all going to the farm to soak the old days.
And then Kate. Your shoes, Rose. The shoemaker says whatever kind of feet you have, only the insides of the soles go down.
Is that a bad thing?
It's neither a bad thing nor a good thing, Rose. It's just distinctive as might be expected.
Corn flour, salt, tapioca. It's all gone up a penny for some reason. Sugar full of bilberry jam, if we ever get the bilberries.
Look at this pack of cloth of vines she got here.
What's wrong with it?
Only 9 cigarettes in it. One of them must have been so wild, they escaped on her.
Doesn't Jack sometimes call you Ockerwood?
Maggie.
Yes, what does it mean?
Ockerwood was his houseboy, Kate says.
Damn it. I thought it was some Healy for gorgeous.
Maggie.
That's the very thing you could do with around here. A houseboy.
And the battery. The man in the shop says we go through these things quicker than anyone in Ballybeck.
Good for us.
I met the parish priest. I don't know what's happened to that man, but ever since Father Jack came up, you can hardly look me in the eye.
That's because you keep winking at him, Kate.
Maybe that's it. The caper, candles, matches. The work's not good enough to clean up on the back hills. He was anointed last night.
I didn't know he was dying.
Not an inch of his body that isn't burnt.
Does anybody know what happened?
Some silly prank from the hills. He knows he's dying, the poor boy. Just lies there moaning.
What sort of prank?
How would I know?
What are they saying in the town?
I know no more than I told you, Christina.
It was last Sunday week, the first night of the Festival of Lunasa. And they would always do every year in the back hills.
Festival of Lunasa? What sort of...
First they had a bonfire beside the spring well. Then they danced around it. Then they dragged the cattle through the flames to banish the devil out of there.
Banish the devil? You do not know the first thing about what happened.
And this year was an extra big crowd of boys and girls. And they were drunk off their heads. And young Sweeney's boy's trousers caught fire. And he went up in flames.
Who told you that nonsense?
They do it every Lunasa, I'm telling you.
And they're savages! I know those people from the back hills. I taught them. Savages, that's what they are. And what pagan practices of theirs are no concern of ours. None whatever. It's a sorry day to hear you speak like that in a Christian home. A Catholic home. All I can say is I am shocked and disappointed to hear you repeating rubbish like that, Rose.
That's what happened. I'm telling you.
All the same, it'd be very handy in the winter to have a wee houseboy to feed the hens. Chup, 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 chup,
chup, chup, chup, chup. Apples, butter, margarine, flour, and wait till you hear. Who's that in the post office today? Maggie, are you listening to me?
Yes.
You'll never believe it. Your old pal, Barney O'Donnell, home from London, first time back in 20 years.
Barney,
absolutely gorgeous.
The figure of a girl of 18, dressed to kill from head to foot. And her hair, as black and as curly as the day she left.
I can't tell you, a film star, Barney O'Donnell. And beside her, two of the most beautiful children I've ever seen. Twins. They'll be 14 next month. And to see the three of them together like sisters, I'm telling you. Twin girls. Identical.
Identical.
Nina and Nora.
Let me say twins are a little blessing.
And wait till you hear. They're pure blonde. Where in the name of God did the blonde hair come from, I ask her? The father, Eric, she says.
He's from Stockholm.
Stockholm?
Where's Stockholm, Abby?
So there you are. Barney O'Donnell married to a Swede. I can hardly believe my eyes. But the same happy, laughing, bubbly Barney asking about everybody by name.
Didn't you remember so?
Knew all about Michael. Knew his age to the very month. Was Agnes still the quickest knitter in Ballybeg? Were none of us thinking about getting married? And weren't we wise?
Did she remember me?
Rose had the sweetest smile I ever saw.
There.
But asking especially for you, Maggie. How were you doing?
What were you doing?
How were you looking? Every time she thinks of you, she says she had a memory of the two of you hiding behind a turf stack, passing a cigarette between you,
laughing and falling about some guy named, what was it, Curly somebody?
Curly McDade. An idiot of a fella. Bold in his egg as a 17.
Bernie O'Donnell. Oh my goodness.
Who should be around for a while?
leaving tomorrow.
You won't see us, though. That's a pity.
Nice names, aren't they? Nina and Nora.
I like Nora. Nice name. Strong name.
Not so sure about Nina. What do you think of the name Nina?
Nina? No, not at all.
Well, if there's a Saint Nina, I'm afraid she's not a microbe. Maybe she's a Swedish saint.
Saints in Sweden? What would it be next?
Love used to say to Prince under her blessing.
You've offered us that cheap wisdom already, Rose.
You've got some flour on your nose, Maggie.
When I was 16, I remember slipping out on Sunday night. Around this time of year, early August. And I met Bernie at the gatehouse, and the pair of us off to a dance at Armstrong. I was getting pestered at the time by a fellow called Tim Carlin. But it was really Brian McGuinness who I was, well, who I was keen on. But of course, he was crazy about Bernie. And the two boys put us on the bar of their bikes, and the four of us headed off to Ardstraw, 50 miles each way. And if Daddy had known, may he rest in peace. And at the end of the night, there was a competition for the couple who had the best military two-step. It was down to three couples. The local Ardstraw couple, wee Timmy and myself, was up to here on me, and Brian and Bernie. They were so beautiful together. People would just stop dancing and gaze. You couldn't help but stare at them. And when the judges announced the winners, they were probably blind drunk. The local Ardstraw couple came first. Timmy and myself came second. And Brian and Bernie came third.
Is it working now, Christina? What's that? Mark Holly. Yes, that's good news.